be heavy lead attached to these rods, and it's a lethal weapon, so be careful how you handle them. When we get up there on the river, I will show you how to do this. It's important because young people with black eyes don't look good. We don't want to go aground. The Columbia River is a big area, but there's lots of shallow spots in it too. So. Lift, lift.
I can't get the thing to turn.
Come on over to the side of the boat. Come on. Come over to the side of the boat. Okay, now raise your rod high. That's it. Wind down now. Wind. Get a couple cranks. That's it. Okay, let's go up again. Just get under control, okay? Under control. You're ready now? Wind and let down. Wind. See, you've got some slack. You got some up. Wind down.
Hurry.
It's good.
Wind down?
I will.
It's heavy.
Yeah, very heavy. Well, why don't you get out there and kiss it?
Okay,
let me
Oh, you can do it. Go. Go for it.
Okay, folks, here's a fish that's got to be close to 7 feet. Way too big, unfortunately. Can you see it?
Yeah.
You got it? So we're going to turn this fish loose. You know, there's a lot of people that fish bigger all their life and have never caught one this big. Me, I've never caught one this big. Are you okay?
I'm hot.
Tony?
I'm real excited.
No. It's a big gap. I think it's a hook.
We'll name this one Henry.
Now look at this mouth on this thing. He's been hooked before. He's got some damage to on the far bottom side there.
How many inches do you think that guy is?
There we go. Look at that.
It's a nice one.
That was a nice fish.
Muscles.
Yeah. So how do your muscles feel right now?
Like jelly.
Like jelly, yeah. Oh, what an experience.
That was well worth the day.
Well worth the day. Yeah, now it's your turn.
Now can you imagine landing that fish on a little old 40-pound Cajun line? It's pretty spectacular. There's a fish that probably weigh 130 pounds, approximately.
That one?
Yeah. Weighed more than you does, didn't it?
Well, thank you.
1955 for surgeon. I personally have never caught one that big. I've had to land some for other folks, you know, just can't do it. But, no, I've never landed one that big.
Well, maybe if we catch another one, we'll just, like, let you take
it. No, I'm not going to take it. No, that's too hard on my back. I've had some interesting things happen, though. I did have a customer on board here a few years ago now that had brought his family. They bought the boat, and there was only five of them. And... Well, he said, come on, Milt, you can fish two today. I said, my back's pretty sore. No, I said, come on. He says, I'll bet you on the first fish. He says, $5. I said, well, if you can do that, let's make it worthwhile. Let's make it 10. Okay. So I went down the they're fishing. I went down the cabin. I got me a rod out. And I baited it up, threw it out in the river, went back down the cabin to pour myself a cup of coffee. And I look up, and the rod was in that pole holder there. And it started going like this, and I went out and I set the hook. Oh, man, that hurt. And I said, Jack, would you come land this fish for me? He did. It was 59 and a half inches. And his sister and his mother both just was on him all day to pay up. Now, don't wait thinking you're going to get one bigger, because it would be pretty tough to beat. Very tough. But I think that's about as large a one as I've ever landed, you know, on my own rod, or had on my rod. I didn't land that one either. It's work. There's one.
Now, get over there.
That's mine.